Good morning children. I am Shivanand Mutt, teacher in physics. Yesterday Miss has discussed completed electricity. I hope you have followed it. We have seen heating effects on electricity chapter and how heat is produced when current is passed through a wire. And now today we are going to discuss the next chapter, which is called magnetic effect of electric current. Last year in class 9th, you know that when a current passes through a wire, it behaves like a magnet. How it behaves like a magnet when current passes through a wire? I will demonstrate, I will explain and make this statement clear by this activity. Okay, this chapter is activity oriented. So what are diagrams will be drawn on the board. Try to pay attention and take down everything nicely. Okay, and I hope you have brought scale, pencil and everything. Neatly you draw the diagram, and what all points are written on the board, try to write down clearly, and afterwards, after completing this chapter, notes will be sent. Okay, children. So just now I told the children how the current carrying wire behaves like a magnet. That we will discuss through this activity. So you can take down this as activity number 1. So we are connecting this to a circuit. So last time in the last chapter I told about the circuit also. And here these are the points x, y. In between we are placing a thick long straight conductor, it is called as a long straight conductor. This is ABCD, is a cardboard on which I have, with a adhesive material, I have pasted the sheet.
a paper sheet, or you can call it as a drawing sheet. And here I is a current, this is the resistor, and this is a battery, positive and negative terminal of a battery, and this is a plug key, and this is a midpoint O which is marked on this paper, and we have placed a small magnetic compass. So this is called as a magnetic compass. So this you can label it as long straight conductor. Magnetic compass. So this XY is a long straight conductor, and I is a current. Here I am labeling the parts. I is current, and R is the resistor. A, B, C, D is a sheet of paper, and K is a plug key, VA is a battery. So this is the experimental setup, children. Here we are taking a cardboard and fixing it horizontally and pasting it with an adhesive material, the sheet on the cardboard, and making a small hole at the center and calling it as a point O. And we are inserting a wire on that. We are inserting a wire, straight conductor, which is called a straight conductor. We are inserting to this horizontal cardboard sheet which is coated, which is pasted with a paper. We are inserting a copper wire. This wire conductor is connected to the resistor, battery and a plug key. By plugging the key, by tapping the key, the current starts to flow. The current starts to flow from positive terminal. So I is a current, I noted, and it passes through the long straight conductor. And here near the conductor we are placing a magnetic compass. What you notice, there is a deflection in the needle. Of the magnetic compass. By this, what you are understanding, children? A current carrying conductor XY produces a magnetic field around it. So this is called as the magnetic effect of electric current. By this, what you are understanding, there is a relationship between electricity and magnetism. Electric current and magnet are related to each other. So if this is the case, question arose to various scientists, if electricity can produce the magnetic effect, why can't a moving magnet induce electric current? That was the big question. So if the electric current induces a magnetic field around it, why can't a moving magnet induce a current? So in this chapter, we are going to study the magnetic effects of electric current which is called electromagnetism, and also the moving magnets, how they will induce electric current. So this can be referred to a very famous scientist who accidentally proved this experimentally. So he was none other than, in 19th century only, Hans Christian Oersted. So this is also, he conducted various experiments when he allowed the current to pass through a conductor. He observed a magnetic field around it by the deflection in the magnetic compass. So this is also called as Oersted's experiment. So this was performed in the 19th century by Hans Christian Oersted, a famous physicist. So this is also called as Oersted's experiment. So due to his different experiments, there was revolution in the field of science and technology. By these activities, by electromagnetism, it was there was able to discover radio, television and optic fibers. So these were the devices which were discovered by the invention of magnetic effect of electric current. So today we will discuss one by one about these things, how the magnetic field, what is a magnetic field, how it is produced, what makes it to produce by different activities, what is magnetic field lines, what are magnetic lines of force, how to draw the magnetic lines of force around a bar magnet. By different activities I am going to explain. Okay children, so I hope you have noted it, taken down. Now next is magnetic field and field lines. Magnetic field and field lines. See, I told about the magnetic compass, no? It behaves like a small magnet. The end pointing towards north. So always when you leave the compass, when you keep the compass near a current carrying conductor, there is a slight deflection, I told. So the end pointing towards north is called north seeking point or north pole. And the end pointing towards south is called south seeking point or south pole. The end pointing towards north is called north seeking point or north pole. And the end pointing towards south is called south seeking point or south pole. So in the previous class children, in 9th standard, I hope you have understood the concepts by different activities, that when north pole of the magnet was brought near the north pole, whether it attracted or repelled, definitely there was a repulsion. When south pole of the magnet was brought near the north pole of another magnet, there was attraction. So like poles of the magnet repel each other, unlike poles of the magnet attract each other. So these are the properties you have learned. What you have learned? Like poles of a magnet
repel each other whereas unlike poles of a magnet attract each other.
Now, after understanding this, there is one in-text question. Just you write down that question. Why does a compass needle
Why does a compass needle
get deflected when brought near a bar magnet?
Why does a compass needle get deflected when brought near a bar magnet?
So, when you bring a compass needle near a bar magnet, a bar magnet contains a field around it, which is called magnetic field. The bar magnet contains the field around it, which is called a magnetic field. It makes the magnetic compass to undergo deflection. A magnetic field is present around a bar magnet which makes the compass needle to get deflected. So, what is that magnetic field and what is magnetic lines of force? So, we will discuss with activity number 2. Note down this much, take down. A magnetic field is present around a bar magnet which makes the compass needle to get deflected. Now we will discuss activity number 2. Take a drawing sheet, fix a paper on that with the adhesive material and keep a bar magnet in the middle of the paper. in the middle of the paper, keep a bar magnet. Take a small salt sprinkler and sprinkle some iron filings near the bar magnet. Small pieces of iron are referred to as iron filings. If you sprinkle, gently you fix this to a stand, gently tap that. Tap the sheet. Slowly all the iron filings arrange themselves around a magnet. Around this magnet, all the iron filings arrange themselves in the form of concentric circles. But here what is you are noticing? Many iron filings are attracted towards the ends of the magnet. Much strength is towards the ends of the magnet because strength is more near the ends, which is these ends are called north seeking or north pole, south seeking or south pole. But other iron filings align themselves around the magnet. You can represent it by the dotted line, but much force is present at the ends of the magnet. So the area around it, around which the magnetic force is present, is called magnetic field. The area around which the magnetic force is present is called magnetic field. The area around which the magnetic force, due to the magnetic force only, all the iron filings are attracted. More iron filings are attracted at the ends of the magnet, which is because of its pole strength. More iron filings you are seeing, no? Here more iron filings are present at the north and the south pole. But some of the iron filings are present at the center also. Here this is called as magnetic field. What it is called as? Magnetic field. And the lines you are observing, the lines around the magnetic, these lines are called magnetic lines of force. The lines surrounding a bar magnet are called magnetic lines of force, or you can call it as magnetic field lines. They are called as magnetic lines of force or magnetic field lines. Any way you can call, magnetic lines of force or magnetic field lines. In short form, MLF or MLF or MFL. Magnetic field lines. Anyway, you can call in short form. So, here by sprinkling in this activity, what you understood? By sprinkling the iron filings near a bar magnet and gently tapping the paper, all the iron filings will align themselves in north, south, direction, but more concentration is towards the ends, which are called the poles of a magnet. So the area around which the magnetic force is present is called magnetic field, and the lines surrounding the magnet are called magnetic field lines or magnetic lines of force. You can shortly denote it as MLF or MFL. Now, how to obtain the magnetic lines of force around a bar magnet? How to draw the magnetic lines of force around a bar magnet? We'll discuss now. Now in activity 3, I will explain how to draw the magnetic lines of force around a bar magnet using magnetic compass. To draw the magnetic lines of force around a bar magnet using magnetic compass, or you can call it as compass needle, any name, both are correct. How to draw the magnetic lines of force around a bar magnet using magnetic compass or a compass needle? Take a sheet of paper and keep a bar magnet on that. See, keep a magnetic needle or a compass needle near the north pole of a bar magnet. The needle deflects towards the south pole. Mark a point. Slowly move the magnetic compass near that point, and again it will show its deflection towards the south pole. Go on, repeat it several times. Repeat by moving the compass wherever the deflection of the magnetic needle takes place. There you go on marking the points. Wherever the deflection you are seeing, you go on marking the points. And again move the needle. Again there is a deflection. So like this, you can obtain the deflection. Here also, you keep the compass here, it will show the deflection here towards the south end. So like this, you join all the points, you will obtain the magnetic field lines or magnetic lines of force around a bar magnet. So by joining, how will you obtain this? You join all the magnetic lines of force. This is north, south. So by joining all these lines of force, you are obtaining a concentric circles from north. The direction is very important, children. You indicate the direction. The magnetic lines of force move from north. They start from north pole and end to south pole. So draw this diagram carefully and see arrow mark where I am marking. From north pole to south pole, they originate like this also, you can tell. They originate from north pole and terminate towards the south pole. But the magnetic field lines inside the magnet will move from south to north. So this figure you take down. So how they start? If you join all these points, they start from north pole and end to south pole. Here you are noticing they all are starting from north pole and ending to south pole. But inside the magnet, they move from south to north. So this is a property. This is the property. Okay. So take down this figure. I will write one, two statements. Below this, you write down. Magnetic field is a quantity that has both magnitude and direction. Is having magnitude also and direction also. The direction of the, here I will write again. So this is first point. Write down below this. The magnetic field is a quantity that has both magnitude and direction. Second point, magnetic field lines originate from north pole and terminate towards south pole. they originate from North Pole and terminate towards South Pole. Or simply you can tell, they start from North Pole and end towards the South Pole. Inside the magnet, magnetic field lines move from South Pole to North Pole. Outside the magnet, where you are seeing the arrow marks, here they are moving from North Pole to South Pole. But inside it is from South Pole to North Pole. Now, magnetic field lines or magnetic lines of force, here you are seeing they are surrounding the magnet in form of a concentric circles. They never intersect or cross each other. Magnetic lines of force do not intersect or cross each other. So this is the property number 4. So this you can call by the heading properties of magnetic lines of force. Properties of magnetic lines of force. Anyhow, I am giving again in in-text, this question is asked. So, I did not write in the side. If there is no place inside, you can write properties. Properties of magnetic lines of force. What is the property number 1? Magnetic field is a quantity that has both magnitude and direction. What is second property? Magnetic field lines or magnetic lines of force, anyone you can use, right? Originate from North Pole and terminate towards South Pole. Children, if you are feeling this little difficult, these words, you can use simple English. Magnetic lines of force start from North Pole and end towards South Pole. And inside the magnet, magnetic field lines move from South Pole to North Pole. What is the property number 4? Magnetic lines of force do not intersect or cross each other. They do not intersect. Why they do not intersect? Because they are originating from different poles. North Pole also, South Pole, in a particular direction. Just now I mentioned how they are originating. From North to South they are moving. And inside from South to North. So the direction will not cross over each other. So that is the reason why they will not intersect. They are having a particular direction of movement. So these lines of force are moving from North to South. So they will not cross over or they will not intersect each other. They are in the form of concentric circles. So this is property number 4. So note these all properties. So how the magnetic field is produced around a current carrying conductor? So that one we will discuss in tomorrow's class, children. So how
you take a current carrying conductor and place a magnetic compass below it or over it, and what changes you are noticing and how the deflection takes place in both the directions, that we will discuss in the next class. Okay children, I hope you have taken down this all. Everything is clear? Okay, fine. Thank you.